First thing, of course, before you lift the weight of the car up into the air, you want to break the torque on all the wheel nuts. Okay, so, and the reason, of course, you want to break the torque before you lift the wheel is because otherwise it's just going to be spinning and you're going to have to try jamming it up. People use their foot to do that. It's just crazy. Go ahead and break the tension off. Just break the tension. I'm not talking about backing these nuts off at all. I'm talking about breaking the tension.
The thing you'll notice, of course, is that I spread out of cardboard underneath me for kneeling on, for keeping my work area clean, keeping myself clean, keeping my tools organized.
Okay, you'll notice I'm using a bottle jack instead of the jack that came with the truck. So if you have a bottle jack, by all means, you should use it. It's probably the safest way to lift a large weight like this. Every vehicle, of course, should have a jack in it. And have a look at my film, Car Jacks 101, where I review a whole bunch of different car jacks from different car manufacturers. Hopefully, the one that's in your car will be recovered, and we'll talk about your safe placement, how to change the spare. Of course, that's another movie.
Get under the frame right here. I'll pick her up. Close the valve. There she goes. Now you'll notice, of course, that I have some clean cardboard spread out on my work site. That's to protect me from the hard and cold ground and keep my clothes clean and to keep my work site contained. If I have a small oil spill, I can keep it contained on the cardboard. And I think you'll find that all professionals are pack rats for big pieces of cardboard, like this moving box that I saved. Okay. See, I'm clear now. I'll take it up a couple more strokes, and then we'll block it up. I like to use a piece of plywood for platform and a proper axle stand. It's the only way to go. You should never, never work on a vehicle that is non-standard. Okay, here we go. I'm using a piece of plywood to spread the load on. I get up as close as I can, and then I'm going to put the weight onto it, off of the jack. As you can see, it's compressing the cardboard and the plywood. And now the weight is snugly on the axle stand instead of the jack. And I can take it out and use the jack to lift up the other side of the vehicle. Again, piece of plywood, axle stand. Okay, once again, I'll just take the weight off of it, nice and easy. Should never go too fast, but as you can see, now it's all standing up on the stands.
The only time you're going to want to see this thing fall, of course, is when the wheels are still on it. So right now, when I've just lifted it up, I've just put it on the axle stands, I give it a shake, it doesn't look like it's going to fall off. Okay, have a look underneath. You can see I'm just on the axle stands. I've planted properly on plywood blocks. Now I can shake this thing all I can, and I'm pretty strong, and it's not coming down. So it's safe to take the wheels off, and it's safe to work on.